So this is seventh lecture on digital electronics. We shall discuss the following topics today. The first one is flip-flop. We'll complete our discussion on flip-flops, and then I will take one example of how to use flip-flop to build digital circuits. We shall talk about the counters. We'll talk about two different kind of counter: ripple counter and synchronous counters. So let me very quickly revise the concept of latch. I told you that in previous class latch can be implemented using NOR gates. This was the circuit for NOR gate based latch. Latch has two input, set and reset, two outputs, Q and Q bar. Output Q is given back to this NOR gate number 2, and the output of complement output is given back to NOR gate number 1. And I told you that generally the latch which is implemented using a NOR gates, the input for this latch will be 0-0 state. I mean both set and reset will be generally 0. Okay. When this set receives 1 and reset remains as it is as 0, then basically because of the property of the NAND gates, as we discussed in the previous class, this Q becomes 1 and Q bar remains 0. And if this set input comes back from 1 to 0 again and this reset remains 0 as it is, then you will see that we have 1 and 0 back. I mean same 1 and 0 at the Q and Q bar outputs. So what you see that if the both inputs set and reset are 0-0, then the out Q and Q bar remains in the previous state. Okay. Previously, when the inputs were 1 and 0, in that case the Q and Q bar were 1 and 0, but if the input set has now moved from 1 to 0, still the output is in 1-0 state. Okay, this is called the memory state. Okay, similarly, if the set is 0 and reset is 1, then the outputs become 1, 0 and 1. That means clear state for the flip-flop. And again, if this reset moves to 0 state from 1 to 0, then flip-flop, the outputs at the flip-flop will remain 0 and 1. So the conclusion is if both inputs are 0-0, the output state doesn't change. Whatever the previous output was, that will, those previous outputs will appear at Q and Q bar terminals. Is it clear? And as I told you that this latch can also be implemented using NAND gates. Okay, the circuit configuration will be just like this. Only difference will be in this kind in the description. Generally, I told you that for NAND gate, the both set and reset inputs were at one state initially. Okay, and then when set input moves from 1 to 0, set moves from 1, this is for NAND gate based latch. So if we consider the set to be 0 and reset input to be 1, then what will happen in this case? The output Q and Q bar will have 1 and 0 states respectively. Okay. Set is 0 means this is set state for a NAND gate based latch. And if both inputs get 1 and 1, then even in this case, this state will, the output state will remain same and it will have 1 and 0 state. And similarly, if set is 1 and reset is 0, then in that case, it goes into the clear state, because reset has moved from 1 to 0 and the outputs in this case become 0, 0 and 1 respectively. And again, if this reset goes back to 1, then the outputs remains in the same state, 0 and 1. This is called memory for this latch, NAND gate based latch. Okay. And in this case, if the both inputs are 0, that state is actually undefined. Okay. Undefined state.
Now a clock RS flip flop here, we shall implement this RS flip flop using the same NAR gate based latch. So the last state is similar to the previous implementation. We have two NOR gates, 1 and 2. Q output, Q bar output. And then at the first stage, we will have two AND gates. Please settle down quickly. So you see here that we have two additional AND gates and one more input, that is called clock input, CT, that is clock input, and essentially it is a square wave like this. Okay, where the T is the time period for this wave, and let's say that T by 2 is the on time period for this wave. Okay, and this circuit can be designed for level triggering or the edge triggering. Okay, level triggering means the circuit will respond if the clock will reach to its maximum value for this duration only. Okay, that will be called the level triggering. And in edge triggering, what will happen when this clock varies from 1 to 0, during the leading edge of this clock pulse like this, when the clock this input, when it moves from 1 to 0, then only the data available at the set and reset inputs, that will be transferred to the next stage. Okay, this is called the edge triggering. Similarly, we will have negative edge triggering, just like this positive edge triggering, where this circuit responds when the input move from 1 to 0. Okay, we can have negative triggering like this. I mean, this circuit will respond in that case when the clock moves from 1 to 0. Here, here, and here, and so on. Okay. So, what you see that in this case, we have an additional control input that is called CP or clock input. Okay. The schematic diagram for this SR flip-flop is drawn like this. The two inputs, set and reset, and the output Q and Q complement. So these are two inputs and two outputs, and apart from that there will be an additional input, that is the clock. This is the clock. Okay, and similarly you should know that sometime you will observe there will be a dot here, okay, so there will be bubble here, so bubble indicates that this SR latch will respond to negative edge triggering, I mean when the clock, it will respond when the clock moves from 1 to 0, I mean the negative edge of the clock, okay, if there is no bubble means this SR latch, this SR flip flop will respond to this edge. And if there is a bubble here, then this SR latch responds to this condition from 1 to 0. Okay, is it clear? And now let me discuss the working principle for this SR latch, SR flip-flop. Okay, what you see here, that in this case, if the clock pulse is 0, at 0 state, then what will happen? The output of this this gate number 3 and 4 will be 0, okay, and since the both inputs of this latch are 0, 0, 0, then the output will be just like Q and Q bar will follow the previous state, whatever it was earlier, okay, and when the clock is 1, then only the input data are allowed to pass to this next stage, okay, when let's say that if clock pulse is 1, then in that case here the actually the output is R into R dot 1, R and 1, and here S dot 1, okay, that means whatever the inputs are, that will be transferred to the next stage, okay, and then its working principle will be similar to that of that simple RS latch, okay. Is it clear? What we have here, additionally we have a clock input, and with the clock input we have got this facility that if clock pulse is 0, no data will be loaded to that RS latch, and when the clock pulse is 1, then whatever the data present at the two inputs, that will be loaded to the RS latch. Okay, and now let me elaborate the behavior of this circuit using this characteristics table for this SR latch. So characteristics table is drawn like this. In the inputs we have the Q. Q is actually the present state, output. Okay, and QT plus 1 is the next state output. That means when this flip flop receive a clock, okay, it may change its output state or it may not change. So whatever the output is after applying that clock pulse is called the next state output, QT plus 1. Okay, QT is basically its present state output. And then the two inputs, those are S and R, set and reset. And here I will write the next state output, that is QT plus 1. Okay, this table is called a characteristics table for this SR flip-flop. Okay, so since we have three columns here, there are three variables, there will be eight possible combinations, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, and 111. Okay. Now let's find out what will be this QT plus 1. That means next state output if the set is 0, reset is 0 and QT is 0. Okay. So from the behavior of this SR flip-flop, you know that if both inputs are 0, set and reset, okay, it will retain the previous output data. Okay. So you see here, this both inputs set and resets are 0 and the previous data is QT. Okay. So when a clock is, if a clock is occur at this moment, the next state output data, the next state data becomes what? What will be the next state data? 0. Because the previous state data was 0 and set and reset was 0. Okay. That's why if the flip-flop is implemented using NOR gate, okay, we generally say that the inputs remains in 0-0 state. Okay. Then what will happen here? If the set is 0, reset is 1, then what will be the next state data? Next state output is always 0 because now the flip-flop, now this SR latch is in reset state. Okay. S0, reset 1, that means it is in reset state. So output 0. Okay. For 010, it is 1 because the state input is 1, reset is 0, therefore the next state output is 1. Okay. Then for 11, again it is not defined. Okay. If the both inputs are 1 and this flip-flop is implemented using NAND gates, NOR gates, basically this input combination is not defined and it is called that this flip-flop is in intermediate state. Is in intermediate state. Okay. Then for this combination, if both set and reset inputs are 0 and the previous state is 1, then what will be the next state? If a clock occurs here, the previous state will be retained. The previous state was 1, so here the next state will also be 1. Okay. And similarly, for this case, if the state is 0, reset is 1, then will get 0 because it is simply reset condition. Okay. If one state is 1, reset is 0, whatever the previous state is, your output has to be 1. Okay. And again for this final combination, when both inputs are 1, it is not defined for this case. It is intermediate state or don't care state for this flip-flop. Okay. Is that clear? Now I can use a K-map and I can find out how this QT plus 1 is related with QT, S and R. So I need to use a 3 variable K-map here. There are 8 blocks in this 3 variable K map where I take QT and set reset 0 1 0 0 0 1 1 1 and 1 0. Okay. I have 1 here, that means for 0 1 0 0 1 0, so this is 1. Then for 100, I have another 1 here. Then for 110, there is a 1, 110. 110, there is a 10. Okay. I also have don't care for this combination. 0, 1, 1. Okay, when QT is 0 and set reset are 1, 1, then basically it is 0, 1, 1. I have don't care condition here. And again a don't care condition here. When QT is 1 and set reset are 1. So it is 1, 1, 1. What is this? Okay, now I can solve this K map. I can make a group of these four variables, these four mean terms, okay, and another group for this and this. And I can write here that 2T plus 1 for this SR flip flop is, this is what? What is this? Yes. And what about this? It is 15. You see R bar. Okay. R complement. Okay. Or you can say that QT plus 1 equal to set plus R dash QT. Okay. So this equation is called a characteristic equation for SR flip flops. You can predict the next state output if you remember, if you have this equation in your mind. Okay. If the all input states are known, then you can write the next state output using this equation for this SR flip flop. Okay. The next one is D flip flop. D flip flop is basically a modified version of RS flip flop. Okay, where one of the input is complemented and given to given to the circuit as a another input in this manner. Okay, let me do this using the NAND implementation of latch. This is our Q output, Q bar output. This is basic RS latch. Okay, then I have a NAND gate here. Another NAND gate here. And this is our D input. Have a clock pulse here. The clock pulse and this D input first complemented and then given to this reset input of the RS flip flop. Okay. Just look at this circuit and compare this with the previous one. Okay, what you have? We had two inputs. For our SR flip flop, okay, and if you are implemented that SR flip flop using NAND gate, this one would be set input, and this one was to be reset input. Okay, this one set, this one is reset. So now set is replaced by T input, and reset is basically the complement of D. Okay. Getting my point. Set is allowed to, set input, the same set input is now renamed as D input, and the reset input is complement of D now. Okay. And therefore, as a result, you see that at this point, if I can write here that I have T bar plus CP bar plus pulse bar, and at this point I had D plus CP bar. Okay. D here means complement of the D bar, and D bar is when NANDed here, then I will get D plus CP bar. Okay. Is it clear? Now, what will happen if this clock pulse input is 1? If the clock pulse input is 1, then the output here is simply D bar, and at this point it is D. Is it or not? Is it clear? If this CP is 1, that means clock high. If the clock is high, CP 1. So CP 1 means here the NAND operation is performed. So NAND operation, CP high means this CP bar is 0. So simply I have D bar plus 0. So here I have D bar, and at this point I will have D. Okay. So compare this with that of the previous SR flip flop. Okay, what we have? If we have D bar here and D here. Okay, D bar means let's say that if our D is initially 0, okay, D is 0, then what will happen? D bar is 1 here, and this D is 0. Okay, so if D bar is 1, then what will happen here? Just recall the property of a NAND gate. NAND gate means if there is any input 1, the output has to be 0. Is it or not? Getting my point? For a NAND gate, if there is any input is 1, the output has to be 0. So if I apply D 0 here, here it will be 1, and that 1 will make this Q to 0. Okay? So the Q is 0. In this case, if D is 0, okay, and what will happen if D is 1? If D is 1, then here I will have D, that is 1. The D bar is 0 in this case. So this D equal to 1 will make this Q bar equal to 0. Okay, so what you see, whatever the input given to this circuit, when the next clock occurs, the same input appears at the output. Okay, if you apply D 0 here, then when next clock pulse appear, the clock pulse appear here, that 1 is transferred to the output. Okay, and similarly, if D is 0 here, the same 0 is transferred to the output if the clock pulse is 1. Okay, so this behavior I can summarize in the characteristics table for this D flip flop. Okay, D flip flop, as you see, that now we will have two inputs only, that is Q, the present state output, and then the D input, and the output will be Q T plus 1. The next state output is, what is that? Q T plus 1. Okay, and in this case I will have four possible combinations: 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1. Is it clear? Now you see here, if Q is 0, previous and next state, I mean previous state output is 0 and D is 0, then what will happen to QT plus 1 if a clock pulse occur? D 0, Q 0. The output will be 0 here. Okay, what about this case? If 0, Q is 0, D equal to 1. If Q is 0, T is 1, it is 1. You have seen that. If the D is 1, the output is 1 after the clock. Okay, it doesn't matter what was the previous state for that flip flop. Okay, so if T is 1 here, then output is 1. If Q is 1, D is 0, then output is 0 because D is 0, and here if the Q is 1, D is 1, then output is 1. Okay. Is it clear? You can see just looking at the characteristics, you can write this QT plus 1 directly in term of Q and D. What you see? Although you can do the same using the two variable K map, but you can directly write it here. QT plus 1 is what? QT plus 1 is D. You just compare this column with this column. Both are same. 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. So whatever the D is, that is going to be QT plus 1 in next, after the next clock pulse. Okay. So characteristic equation for this T flip flop is QT plus 1 equal to T. Okay. D means you can say delay. Okay. Whatever the input is, after certain delay, once the clock pulse has occurred, that is going to appear at the output. Okay. That's why it's called D flip-flop. Basically, it is used to load the other flip-flop. This flip-flop is used to store data to load other flip-flops, okay, or other circuits. Getting my point? So, QT plus 1 is simply T in case of this D flip-flop. Next one is JK flip flop. You see that in case of SR flip flop, the 1-1 input combination was the problem. Okay, when both input was 1, the outputs were undefined in that case, because 0-0, both Q and Q bar cannot be 0. Okay, so basically that problem is sorted out in this JK flip flop. Okay, that means when both inputs are 1, in that case output is no more undefined in this case. Okay, let's see how it happens. So the last stage for this JK flip flop is again can be implemented using NAR gate. We know that the latch stage is common for all flip-flop, be it a SR flip-flop or JK flip-flop or D flip-flop. Okay. Sometime I am implementing that with NAR gates. You can also do the that implementation with NAND gate. In that case, the input will be changed slightly. I mean, set will be replaced by reset and reset will be replaced by set. Okay. So this first stage is common for even for this JK flip-flop, and then here I will have AND gate just like our SR flip flop. The clock pulse is common, the clock input, clock pulse is common here. Then there will be J input here and K input here, that's why it is called JK flip flop, J input and K input. Okay, this AND gate will also receive another input, the complement, that is the complement output. Here Q output, the complement output is here. So this complement output is given back to this AND gate, and similarly this output is given back to this AND gate. Okay. So 1, 2. This is again a two input, two output flip flop. J and K are the two inputs, and the output is Q and Q bar. Okay, the only difference between this JK flip flop and SR flip flop is this third input to this AND gate 3 and 4. Okay, and how this feedback helps here. You can see that in SR flip flop, the 1-1 input combination was problem. I mean, when both S was 1 and R was 1, okay, the both outputs were 0-0. That was the problem. See how this problem is sorted out here. Imagine that at a particular moment, the both J and K inputs are 1. J is 1, K is 1. Okay. And clock pulse is also 1. So this clock pulse is high. So clock pulse is also 1. So this input is also 1. And this input is also at 1. This one, this is at 1. This is at 1. This one is at 1. Okay. And let's see that, let's assume that the previous state was 0-1 state. That means it was a reset state. In reset state, Q is to be 0 and Q bar is to be 1. That was the previous state. Okay. So what will be the third input now? The third input is here, this 0 will come back as a input. Okay. And for this AND gate, for the AND gate number 4, the 1 comes back here as an input. Okay. So what you see, the output for this AND gate is 1, whereas the output for this AND gate is some 0. Okay. So you see how that 1-1 state problem was sorted out. If the both inputs were 1-1, that is actually now converted to 0-1. Is it or not? Now it has been 0-1 state for this latch. Okay. And that problem no more exists. And similarly, you can check this for another output combination. If the output is 1-0 in place of 0-1, then you see this 1 is given back here and this 0 is given back here. So the output of this AND gate is now 0 and the output of this AND gate is now 1. Okay. So basically we have a kind of set state in this case, sorry, reset state in this case, okay, and the output has to be 0. There is no undefined state in this case. The 1-1 input states are no more problem for this JK flip-flop because of this feedback arrangement, okay. And the behavior of this can again be summarized using a characteristics table. Let me draw that one. The three inputs are the previous present state QT, J input and K input. The output is, let's say for this table, the next state output is QT plus 1. Okay. So if I write here 0, 0, 0, what will be the output now? QT plus 1. What will be the next state output in this case? If J is 0, K is 0 and previous state is 0. If there is no 1-1 input, okay, its behavior is similar to that of a SR flip flop. Okay, so if both inputs are 0, 0, 0, then the output will be same as the previous state, that is 0. Okay, then for the next combination 0, 0, 1, what is going to happen? This is what? This is a reset state. Okay, set is 0, reset is 1. Set state is 0, reset is 1. So output has to be 0 irrespective of the previous output state. Okay, so whether this QT is 0 or 1, if J is 0, K is 1, then basically it is 0 output. Read or not? Then for 0, 1, 0, the output is 1, set state. Okay, and for 0, 1, 1 now, let's look at this discussion. When we assume that the, let's say that the previous state were 0 and 1. Okay, the Q is 0. And then 1 appears here. Okay, clock is 1. So if this is 0, then this 0 has come back here, 0. This 1 has come back here, 1. So this output is 0 and this output is 1. Okay, so now the latch is in which state? Set or reset? Set state. Because this was to be set input and this one was to reset input. If you implement this using a NOR gates. Okay, so this has gone into now set state and therefore the output has become now 1. Okay. Once the next clock pulse appears, because this RS latch goes into set state, the output has to be 1. Okay, that means what you notice here, if the previous state was 0 and the both inputs J and K were 1, the output is complemented. Okay, it's complement of the previous state. Previous output was 0, so next output has to be 1. Okay, it's a complement of the previous state if the both inputs were 1, 1. Okay, now what about this 100? If the QT is 1, previous state output is 1, J is 0, K is 0, previous state output remains as it is. Okay, so this output is 1 now. If it is 101, then it is a reset state. Reset means it is 0. Then in 110 case, set state. So it is 1. Then what about 111? The previous state is 1, J and K are now 1. So the output will be complemented. Okay? So I can write here for this 11. Here, the output is 0. Okay. I can summarize the things in this manner. Let me take the input column as a J and K, and the output is 2T plus 1. And I can write here 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. Okay. So QT plus 1 can be directly written in terms of QT or 0, 1. Okay, if the both inputs are 0, 0, 0, then the QT plus 1, the next state output depends upon the previous state. Whatever the previous state was, that will be the next output. Okay, so if the previous state was QT, then this QT plus 1 has to become QT, if the inputs were 0, 0. Okay, if the inputs are 0 and 1, then basically it is a reset state. So the previous output doesn't matter. Whatever the previous state output is, the output here has to be simply 0. Okay. What about this case? 1, 0. If the 1, 0, the output is to be 1. Previous state doesn't matter. Okay. And what about this 1, 1? QT bar. Okay. It's the complement of the present state. I can write it like this. Okay. So this is the summary of this bigger table. Okay, you can easily remember this manner. Okay, so this is JK flip flop. Here the 1-1 problem was sorted out. And the symbol for this JK flip flop is two inputs J and K, outputs are Q and Q bar. Okay, so output Q Q bar, input J and K, and there is a clock pulse. So this clock pulse, if it is made in this manner, means it is for positive edge triggering. If the clock pulse is moving from 0 state to 1 state, then only the output will change. Okay. And if I again put a dot here, then it is for negative triggering. That means when clock is moving from, changing from 1 state to 0 state, then only the output will change with this dot. Okay. Is it clear? I forgot to mention, but for D flip flop, again you can make a schematic diagram in a similar fashion. There is only one input in this case, D, clock pulse, and the output Q and Q bar. This is a schematic diagram for D flip flop. Okay, this is for JK flip flop. For JK flip flop, you have two inputs. For D flip flop, only one input. Okay. Clock pulse. Okay.